Tonight, Beijing is reimposing restrictions in many parts of the city in response to a new cluster of COVID cases. As other countries emerge from months of lockdown, the new outbreak there is a reminder of how difficult the road to recovery could be. And questions are still being asked about China's early handling of the outbreak. The first case of COVID-19 was in the city of Wuhan, probably at the beginning of December last year. In total, there were nearly 4,000 deaths and over 50,000 infections. And our China correspondent John Sudworth has just returned from a visit to Wuhan. He sent this report.
For 2 months, time stood still in this city as it endured one of the world's harshest lockdowns. Now, it seems a distant memory. Interrupted lives have resumed again. But beneath the appearance of normality, the authorities are on edge. People we arranged to meet are followed by plainclothes police.
There, she took the photo off there, look.
Who block our car.
Why are they doing this?
We're stopped from filming.
We can't leave.
And at this apartment block, a group of officials keeps a careful eye on us.
Have we been detained?
During the lockdown, anger erupted here over how it was managed, with a national vice minister heckled on an official visit. It's all fake, they shout. It was a sign of how the crisis shook the foundations of a system, one now firmly back in control. No interviews, she's told. People may say something they don't mean, this official says, explaining his concern about our filming. In January, Wuhan's health service was the first to experience the onslaught. But despite evidence the disease was spreading, the public was given little warning. Doctors were silenced by the police. And one of them, Li Wenliang, later died. At a small shrine, an offering is made to a dead brother. Ms. Wong, who doesn't want to use her full name, has been told by the police not to talk to the foreign media, but has chosen to ignore that warning. 44-year-old Wong Fei died in early February in the same hospital as Dr. Li Wenliang. They should have warned the public in time, his sister tells me. If they hadn't covered it up, my brother might be alive now. Anyone asking similar questions too publicly is quickly silenced. For China, there is now only one narrative that matters in Wuhan: the undoubted success in eventually bringing the virus under control.
China is determined that this place will not be remembered for a cover-up that put global health at risk, but rather as the cornerstone of a great national victory, one that demonstrates not the weaknesses of tight political control, but its strengths.
In Wuhan's night market, business is still slow. But by the crayfish stalls, there's only patriotism and praise. Chinese people united to control the epidemic, this man tells me. But you foreigners don't know how to protect yourselves.
That guy in the black top.
Yeah, he's going to stop at it.
Here's another difference. Outside one of the hospitals, a nurse we've just interviewed is intercepted by the police and questioned.
They're pulling her over. Of course, if it brings you trouble, we won't use your interview.
She calls us later and asks us to delete the interview. It is harder to fight a virus in the face of public criticism and democratic debate. But without them, might China miss the signs of the next public health crisis too? On tomorrow night's programme, Most scientists think the virus came from bats, via an animal in a market, then to humans. But we'll also visit the labs, from which the US claims the virus was leaked. John Sudworth, BBC News, Wuhan.